Panbowl Lake is a geographic feature in Breathitt County that is part of what makes the city of Jackson unique. The area around the man-made lake includes a neighborhood, hospital, school, businesses, and the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet's District 10 office. Panbowl Lake used to be part of the North Fork of the Kentucky River, but that changed in the 1960s with the construction of Kentucky Highway 15.
When the road was built, the lake was impounded through a series of three embankments that serve as dams, two of them on Kentucky 15, one of them on Washington Avenue.
The highway separates Panbowl from the river at the west embankment. There is a spillway riser near the east embankment, which leads to an outlet water channel that runs parallel to Kentucky 15 and under Washington Avenue by way of a culvert and flap gate. The outlet is necessary when water levels on the lake go above a normal elevation of 713 feet.
There's a vertical pipe that connects to a horizontal concrete box culvert that runs underneath Kentucky 15 and channels the water into the old riverbed channel between Kentucky 15 and Main Street, and then through the gate system in Washington Avenue, and then into the main channel of the Kentucky River North Fork as it exists now.
In late February 2021, extensive rainfall caused historic flooding in eastern Kentucky. The North Fork of the Kentucky River crested at just over 39 feet in Jackson, the 10th worst flood in recorded history for this community. Jackson had not experienced flooding this severe since 1984. Not only was the river level high, Panbowl Lake reached an elevation of nearly 729 feet, about 16 feet above normal. Water from the river began seeping through the west embankment, causing a stability issue for the slope.
It appeared that maybe some water was flowing back from the river back into the lake because you had the rushing floodwaters from the river trying to make that bend there where the cut through had been done up against the embankment.
Kentucky Transportation Cabinet personnel responded quickly to the west embankment slip, placing sandbags and later geotextile fabric and rock to prevent further erosion. Ultimately, the dam did not breach and Kentucky 15 remained open to traffic. Since that historic flooding event, KYTC initiated an engineering study to evaluate the condition of the embankments and identify possible improvements. There is also a plan to widen both Kentucky 15 and Washington Avenue, so the engineering report will be used to help inform the design of that project.
What we've tried to do is look at some short-term solutions that can be incorporated into the longer-term permanent widening project that will be hopefully coming along in a few years.
KYTC has already replaced the debris gate over the east embankment riser and cleared out vegetation as recommended by the study. With available funding, the next improvement will be a driven sheet pile wall installed at the west embankment to create a more impervious cutoff from the river. Panbowl Lake remains a floodplain, but these improvements will help prevent future lakeside flooding and maintain the structural integrity of the Kentucky 15 Dam.
One thing we want to do here is to ensure not only the safety of the residents that live along the lake, but we have to ensure that Kentucky 15 remains a viable highway. It's a major artery from southeastern Kentucky to central Kentucky.